Everyone remembers that where they were on March 2nd, whether you were actually in the line of destruction or at home watching that severe weather coverage on your TV. For the first time, though, we're hearing from a couple, Mike and Freda Montgomery. Their story is pretty amazing. Take a look at this, because it seems like it should be the plot from a movie.
On March the 2nd, almost a year ago, a tornado that hit Henryville, Indiana.
Sit down with Freda and Mike Montgomery, and you'll be captivated by their story.
Sort of a day like any other day. We hadn't really made any plans to do anything other than, you know, yes, we knew that there was going to be some storms come through.
But they never imagined the strength of the storm as the two tornadoes merged at the couple's trailer on Henryville Otisco Road.
I remember going up toward the ceiling. But when I got there, the ceiling was gone. And then after that, I don't remember anything.
That's because Mike was struck in the head by flying debris. He woke up face down in the mud. But Freda remembers everything.
But it was so quiet. It wasn't loud. It was just like a thief in the night.
She was sucked into the funnel cloud and says she had an eye on her husband the whole time.
Imagine being on the inside of a washing machine on the spin cycle, going 174 miles an hour. That's exactly what the top part looked like.
As she dropped to the bottom of the twister, she calls it surreal, spending minutes that felt like hours dodging debris.
I remember being thumped on the ground and then being thrown.
Mike and Freda were actually inside the trailer, which was right here as the tornado was approaching. But after all was said and done, the couple was tossed about 350 feet into this field. The trailer was completely gone, and all that was left in its place was this van.
That's where we were laying, right there.
And that's where they stayed for 45 minutes through softball-sized hail and cold rain as first responders cut through fallen trees to reach them.
Yeah, well, it's more than luck had to be, because there's not many people that fly through the funnel and come out the other end and tell about it.
They lived, but both continue to recover from their massive injuries 1 year later.
Due to the injury in my back, I guess I contracted a disease that's rare, that comes from the dirt and the soil.
Injuries they'll have for the rest of their lives. And though 80% of what was inside their trailer is gone, the two have had things returned to them, including business cards and checks blown as far away as Maysville, Ohio. And they're each trying to move on with the best possible attitudes. Now, the Montgomerys both say they're going to try to attend all of today's events. That was the first time they'd ever spoken on camera to anybody about their experience. It was kind of a healing thing, but it did take them a full year to really want to tell that story out loud. They say that they're going to try to clean up the property. It was actually Mike's brother's property that they were living on at the time. They're going to try to get that cleaned up just as soon as Mike recovers from a recent shoulder surgery.